beach in Kauai, and we want to bring you to the village of Nyaneshwari from this park. I'm in chapter 15, and I'm going to start on to week 36. Without detachment, the mind is not going to stay anywhere. God had decided this after consideration. Now, the type of liberation that will be attached to the mind, the desires of liberation, man by itself, that also omniscient God has seen. Like that, this whole world is evanescent. When one comes to know this, the detachment will come after him. Even though penance pushes it away. Now, how this world is evanescent, that the Master of Universe, Sri Krishna, will tell itself. Will tell with the allegory of a tree in the 15th chapter. The accidentally uprooted tree, lying with roots in the air, will wither quickly. Understand, this tree is not like that. With this one allegory, the God marvelously finishes the topic of the trips of the worldly life, that is, cycles of birth and death. So, the worldly life is a falsity and to take conceit of oneself, ego of oneself, to the place of soul, self-form. For this chapter 15 is used by God, Sri Krishna. All this purport from the book Gita shall be explained in detail. Listen with attention, Sri Krishna. Is the ocean of eternal bliss. The full moon day and the king of Dwarka, thus he said, "Hey, son of Pandu, Arjuna, while we are coming to the home of soul, the illusion of universe brings obstacles. This illusion in the form of universe is not the world, but understand, it is a big mighty tree. But this is not like an ordinary tree, with roots at the bottom and branches at the top. So, no one should draw it or describe it. If it was like other trees, when the fire or an axe enters at the bottom, the upper growth, whatever expanse it had, topples down when severed at the bottom. The upper growth, whatever expanse it had, topples down when severed at the bottom. But does this happen to this tree of life? No. So this is not an ordinary tree. Arjun, this miracle is extraordinary. To describe, because this tree grows downwards. Does anyone know how high sun is, but its rays spread at the bottom into a lattice? Like that, miraculous is this tree of life. The water of inundation occupies all of the sky. Like that, whatever space there is or is not, this tree occupies all that. When sun sets, then the night is occupied by darkness. Like that, this alone occupies the entire sky. Hey, Arjuna, if you want to taste, it has no fruit. If you want to smell, it has no flower. Whatever there is, that is only this tree. It has roots in the air, but it is not uprooted. That is why it is evergreen. Though I said it has roots in the air, still it has also has many roots below going down. It is like rapidly growing water grass. It also is like a banyan tree or a holy fig tree because it has branches amidst aerial roots. Also, hey Arjun, this tree of life has branches only at the bottom. Even that is not so, as many groups of branches are seen spreading at the top too. It looks like as if the sky is decorated with vines, or the wind has expanded into this tree, or three states have arisen in this form of tree of life. Understand, this tree is such a one, with the form of universe and with roots up in the air. Now, how its top portion looks, the roots it has, what are its characteristics, why it also grows downwards, how are its branches, or the roots this tree has downwards, which are they, which and what are its branches up in the air, why it is known as Ashwatha tree, fig banyan tree. The purpose given to this tree by experts in the spiritual knowledge, all these things, Arjuna, will be told clearly with explanation, so you can understand and experience this very well. We will stop here today. Come again to join me in Read Jnaneshwari along with me. In the next chapter, we'll elaborate more on this tree of life, or the tree with roots up in the sky. Thank you very much for joining me today. Come again. I was at Papua Beach in Kauai, Hawaii. Thank you.